give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever.
In our 4 decades of singing, I've met a lot of people who need hope. And I'm glad that we have had that hope to offer people, the hope of the world, Jesus Christ.
Now, live in concert at the Renaissance Center in Dixon, Tennessee, America's favorite family of gospel music, the Hoppers.
There's a roadway through the desert. It's called the King's Highway. It's leading to a city that shall never pass away. It's a city that Abraham saw when he followed God's command. It's a city John saw coming down, and it's built by God's own hand.
I know
we're just
traveling in a weary land.
We're seeking that city we call home.
I'm watching for the wall,
and I'm looking for the gate,
and I long to join the chorus,
gather round my Father's throne.
None shall travel on this highway but the pure in heart, whose garments have been washed as white as snow. This road is long and dusty, and oh, I get so thirsty, but I'm drinking from the well of living water as I go. I know
we're just
traveling in a weary land.
We're seeking that city we call home.
I'm watching for the walls,
and
I'm looking for the gates, and I long to join the chorus,
gather round my Father's throne.
Shouted to Goliath, "Boy, it's time for us
keep on walking. God will never leave you all alone. You gotta keep on walking. Just keep on walking. If God has led you out, He'll lead you home. Listen, you might be discouraged, don't want to turn and run, but just keep on walking, 'cause we're headed.
Saved. That's so important in our lives. I remember when I was saved, it was a hot summer night. Not only was I saved, but my three brothers were saved the same week during that revival. And I've never forgotten that. And you know, I contribute that to my mom. My mom was a God-fearing Christian who took on the responsibility to get our family up early on a Sunday morning. And we used to walk some 3 to 4 miles to a little country church. Then we'd attend Bible school, and we'd walk home, and we didn't think a thing about it. But it's so important that you know Christ as your personal Savior as a young boy or a young girl, because you're going to need Him in the life to come.
The night that I accepted Christ, we were at a little church up in the hills of West Virginia, and the visiting evangelist, Phil Hoskins, told the story of the young boy who had gone off to college, and the years that he was in college, he kind of got in with the wrong crowd, and one Sunday morning those guys were going to go out bike riding rather than going to church, and invited him to come along. And so they went out into the country and were riding their bikes, and they went past a little country church that was ringing the bells for Sunday morning service. And as they were getting further away from the church, those bells were getting quieter and quieter, and finally, the boy spoke up to his buddies and he said, "Guys, you know, I'm going to go back. I'm going to go back to church while I can still hear the bells ringing." And that really stood out in my mind. And I knew that I wanted to accept Christ while I could still hear His voice.
I grew up in gospel music, traveling with my family on probably just about every weekend of the month, as much as I could go. And I always enjoyed being a part of the concerts and church services. And I was very, very young. And growing up in gospel music, I guess you feel like at times that that's all you need in your life, that will suffice. Or maybe because your family are Christians, that will take care of your personal life. But I realized a few years later in life that I needed that personal relationship, one-on-one with Jesus Christ. And that night, I was gloriously saved.
Been washed away, and I'll offer joy in my heart since the burdens rolled away, and I'll sing of His love today.
Yes.
Of how I'm saved.
I want to say it's a joy to be here. Jesus changed my life as a teenager, and He's been so good to me and my family. I'm from a family of 11 children, 8 boys and 3 girls, born and raised on a tobacco farm at the foothills of Blue Ridge Mountains. My dad was a sharecropper. I cherish the memories I had. I go back to my childhood days. The old home place that's there was born and raised in a 4-room house, or 2 rooms upstairs and 2 down. I have a wonderful family. I mean that. We have a great time, and I appreciate my immediate family that travels with me all the time.
And what a blessing it is.
It is a blessing. Dean is our golfer in our family. He went out the other day with his driver, and he hit the prettiest ball right straight down the fairway, and it began to slice off, and it rolled up into the woods. Now, if you're a golfer, you don't use your drive again. But he took out that drive again, and that ball rolled up to a big old anthill. And he took that driver out, and he swung at that ball, missed it, hit that anthill. Killed half the ants. Drew back with that drive again, swung at it, hit that anthill again, killed them all except 2. And one ant said to the other, if we're going to live, we got to get on the ball. And he said to the pastor, our pastor, Reverend Broomfield, he said, is it a sin to play golf on Sunday? And he said, Dean, it's a sin for you to play golf any day.
Repent.
But I appreciate Dean so much. But, honey, I want our granddaughter to come out here again. And she is special. And got some more sugar for me? I'm over here.
She's traveled with us since she was born, really. So she's quite a few years. And I used to, my room, mine and Claude's room, used to be in the back of the bus. Well, it's been in the back a couple of 3 times. And it's kind of rough in the back of the bus. All the bumps, you feel it back there. One night, I guess he was hearing a strange noise, and he said, what's that noise I hear? And I said, that's my skin wrinkling. So I've been on that bus 40 some years. But when this little girl came along, it was really special. We had books, we had all kind of books, and we would just file them by the mattress, between the mattress and the wall of the bus. And when she'd come back there and crawl up on that top bunk with me, she'd pick out the book that she wanted to read. And we would read those books, and she would stay back there with me, and we'd have the best time. And we were crossing Canada, and somebody gave her a little book entitled I'll Love You Forever. Well, I'd never seen that book, and I was an older lady, had never seen that little book. But Carly said, let's read this one. And she was about 3 years old, I think. And so it's the story of a woman who had a little boy. And late at night, after she'd gotten him to sleep, she'd go in and pick him up out of the crib. And she'd rock him back and forth, and she'd sing, I'll love you forever. I'll like you for always. As long as I'm living, my baby you'll be. He grew and he grew, and he had a messy room, and he did all the things that little boys do. And he was about 12 years old. Didn't matter. She'd go in at night, and she'd pick that little boy up. She'd rock him back and forth and back and forth, and she'd sing, I'll love you forever. I'll like you for always. As long as I'm living, my baby you'll be. Well, he grew up. He moved away, got him an apartment, he got him a job. And he didn't come home all the time. So late at night, she'd get into her car. And she had a station wagon. And she'd put a ladder in there. And she'd drive over to his apartment. She'd put that ladder up to the window. She'd climb in that apartment. She'd get in there and she'd pick up that big old boy. And she'd rock him back and forth and back and forth. She'd sing, I'll love you forever. I'll like you for always. As long as I'm living, my baby you'll be. Well, he got married. He didn't come home much. And one day she called him and she said, son, if you want to see mom, you better come home. So he got in his car and made his way to her house. Got up to her bedroom. She couldn't get out of that bed. And he reached down and he picked up that little mom. Sat down in that rocking chair and he says, I'll love you forever. I'll like you for always. As long as I'm living, my mama you'll be. And so the story ended. And by that time, tears were just streaming down my face. I just couldn't help it. I was crying. And Carly was looking up at me with these big old eyes. She looked at me and she said, you are grandma. I'll love you forever. As long as I'm living, you'll always be grandma. And I think of a mother who had a son, and she was at the cross the day he was crucified. And if any of you saw the movie, The Passion, just think of her face. And what was in her face the day that she looked at that cross. But think of what was in her face and her heart when he was raised from the dead. She cries.
She holds him close, her baby son, as wise men view the Holy One. So amazed at what she's done. She cries. She draws him gently to her breast, his tiny feet and hands caress, not knowing just why she was blessed. And she cries. She cries with tears of joy. She holds her baby boy at last, and she cries.
Good, Kim.
She sees three crosses on the hill. She knew at once the Father's will. So struck with grief, her heart stands still. she cannot hide as her own son is crucified. She cries with tears of pain. The darkest day she's ever known. How could they leave him here? Another time, another place, she looks upon the Master's face, and the sorrow's gone, and the pain erased, and she cries, so amazed, how could this be? But now it's all so clear to see, she bows before His Majesty. She bows before His Majesty. She cries. She cries with tears of joy. The waiting now has passed. She holds her risen King at last. And she
our 4 decades of singing, I've met a lot of people who need hope. And I'm glad that we have had that hope to offer people, the hope of the world, Jesus Christ. I mean, I see a lot of young people who need hope. And I can think of one in particular who needed hope. They said, I just feel hopeless. And I introduced them to Jesus, and they asked Christ to come into their heart. And later, they said, you know, I still have depression, and I still have down times, but I do not have that hopeless feeling. One night, Gloria Gaither and I were talking about hope. And I said, could you write us a song about that? And she went away, and about 3 weeks later, she stepped up on our bus, and she and Bill had written this next song, Hope.
Brand new song.
Within us, erupting from the sand, is clear and pure refreshment in dry and barren land. No scorching circumstances can stop that eager flow of hope that springs eternal. Blessed Jesus, my strong and saving eye.
you folks are great, I'm telling you. You're just wonderful to sing to. Honey,
we've got another song about hope. Yeah. Why don't we sing it? Mike sings on it.
Yeah. Well, honey, I think I'm running the program.
I'll let him think that anyway.
Oh, I saw the women smile there just a little bit.
But, you know, you don't know the lineup, because I want to feature this young guy at the piano. He's 20 years old.
And
I don't know whether the camera's on him or not, but he is truly a great blessing and one of the finest musicians. And this is all he's ever wanted to do in his entire life is play gospel music. And I appreciate people. Yes.
That was his daddy right there that said amen.
But this guy, you know, I want to feature him on a song. And you prepared, buddy. And I want you to smile. And he's always telling me how great he is. Walked down the hall on the bus the other day and opened up the restroom door. And he was standing in front of there. We have a full-length mirror. And he was singing how great they are. So you folks be the judge how great he is. Listen to Josh Simpson plays for you.
On every new recording project, we try to add at least one a cappella song to the project. And on this particular one, we added the old song, The Solid Rock.
And by the way, you did a good job singing the bass on this.
Thank you, Pop.
Boys, I remember the first group that I ever heard sing a cappella. Claude, do you remember that we worked a half a day on Friday and then we all jumped in that car and drove as fast as we could?
54 Plymouth,
whatever it was, it made it to Washington, D.C., where we went to Constitution Hall.
Well, that tells us what decade we're talking about here.
Absolutely.
Early 60s, okay. And that night, the Blackwood Brothers, the Statesmen, several groups, and but the Weatherford Quartet came on stage, and they did He Hideth My Soul a cappella. And I was captivated, and I have never forgotten that moment. And the a cappella songs are great.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. When darkness veils His lovely face, I rest on His unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the
shall come with trumpet sound. Oh, may I then in Him be found, dressed in His righteousness alone, faultless to stand before the throne. On Christ the solid rock I
forest and all of the ground is sinking sand.
First time I ever went to Israel, they took us to the place they call Jacob's Well. And out of all the times that I've been back there, I've never been able to go back there because it's in an area that they say is not safe. But I remember at that well, a little white-haired grandma began to sing, "There is a fountain filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners plunged beneath that flood lose all their guilty stains." Let's sing about the well. You want to? I was at the well one day when a man came by that way, though he gave me a living spring. He told me of all my wrongs, of everything I'd ever done, but with compassion in his voice, his words of Jesus made
I love that song there. He's made me whole too, many, many years ago. I serve a God tonight that didn't tell me that I had to go home and change anything about me before he would accept me. He accepts me as I am tonight. I serve a God that stands with his arms open wide, invites us in. Those that are troubled, they've got trials and burdens in their life, and the worst, I guess, burden would be to not have Christ in our heart. And he stands and says, whosoever will. Don't go home. You ain't got to go cut your hair. You ain't got to go dress up in a suit, put a tie on. I accept you just as you are. And you know what? That's the purpose tonight in the songs that we sing, is to, we'll just try to get them to the cross. We'll let Jesus do the changing. You know, if there's changing to be made. I know we're not perfect by any means whatsoever, but God can change your life. And this song that Kim's going to do, it's a kind of a, if you'll, the symbolic meaning in it, that Christ is standing there at the river. There's a river that started flowing 2,000 years ago, and in that river there's healing, there is salvation, there's whatever you need, and that river's still flowing tonight here. And for whatever you need in your life, just come to the river. And I want you to listen. It's a special intro with a tremendous message as she sings for you. It's called The River. Listen.
That we all need. So come.
His cleansing blood will wash and clean you if you only will. So come on and meet me down by that river, and we'll dive in like the little children do, and let our troubles wash to the Father. He'll wash you clean and He'll make you new. He'll wash you.
He took willingly for our salvation. He laid His life down. His precious blood fell like tears to the ground. Great is the mercy. Great is the love. Great are my many sins, but for the blood I'd still be drowned. With all my good, I tried to earn grace, but there's no way I could. If I gained this whole world, I'd still be lost. Without the blood Jesus shed on the cross. Yeah.
You folks are just tremendous, and I can't say enough great things about you. And I just appreciate you all being a part of this video. But here's a song. It brings back a lot of memories to me. I used to milk cows, and we milked 3 cows before I went to school every morning. And
this is going to be one of them sad stories again.
No, it's not sad. It's positive. I appreciate where I came from. And I carried the milk to the spring. That was our refrigeration. We didn't get power to our farm until I was 13 years old. I remember some weekends I wouldn't feel good on Monday. And I had a positive cow, after you milk 2. Man, I had one, and just all I had to do is just hold on, and she'd jump up and down for me.
We're going to edit that part out. That's a little too close. Talk about the song.
But just shut up. Can you do that? Thank you. Here's a true story. Of course, it's written many, many years ago. My mother loved the former governor, Jimmy Davis. And the first time I heard this song, I fell in love with it. My brothers and I recorded it back in the early 60s. And they asked me if I would sing one. I said, yeah, I'll do this one. So I love it. Let's do it. A boy in days of childhood, I used to play till evening shadows come, then winding down old familiar pathway, I heard my mother call at set of sun.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Come home, come home, it's supper time. The shadows lengthen fast. Come home, come home.
Summertime,
we're going home at last. Some of the fondest memories of my childhood was woven around supper time. When Mom used to call from the back steps of the old home place, she said, come on home, son, it's supper time. Oh, I'd like to hear that voice once more. But for me, time has woven a realization of a truth that's even more thrilling. That's when the call comes from the portals of glory. Come on home, son. It's supper time. And all of God's children shall sit down with the Lord himself for the greatest supper time of them all. In visions, now I see her standing young. And her familiar voice I hear once more. Banquet tables ready up in heaven. It's supper time around that golden shore. Come home. The shadows lengthen fast. Come home, come home, it's supper time.
Supper time. It's supper time.
Supper time.
We're going home at last.
Yeah.
Do you still have joy?
Oh. One day I was walking in a world of sin, no rest for my weary soul. But then I met a man who said he'd be my friend. All my burdens he did roll. God took those worldly desires, gave me heavenly fires. Now I've got a brand new goal. And since I met this man called Jesus Christ, that happy day. Joy in my hands, joy in my feet, joy in every way. God took those worldly desires, gave me heavenly fires. Now I've got a brand new goal. And since I met this man called Jesus Christ, I've got the joy, joy, joy in my soul.
My new life began.
Lost rivers, desert places I've known.
Songs, don't you? We sort of went back and got songs that we loved, but we never got to record them because somebody always sang them so good. So we just decided that we would sing a few of them. And this is a song that Kim and I think Ben Spear and Ivan Parker sang at Vestal's homegoing on New Year's Day of this year. Vestal Goodman. She was always a person that I looked up to, and I just always. We worked with them a lot in the 60s and got to know them real well. And she was always such a great friend. All of the Goodmans were. But this is a song they sang that I loved so dearly. And tonight I know you're going to enjoy it again. Kim, won't you sing What a Lovely Name?
Reaching higher far. Satisfied. Woo!
I tell you what, you folks will stay with us. We're going to do a Christmas project right after this. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. A tremendous group of people. You know what? Tonight, if we could ask anything from you for our family, the greatest thing you could do for our family is to pray. It's the greatest tool that the Christian has, and many times I think we use it the least. And the Bible says the prayers of a righteous man availeth much. We'd like to close tonight with this song, and after this, I've asked you to pray for us, and we want to pray for you before you leave here this evening. The song says, mention my name every day.
Talking to Jesus, would you?